Hello everyone and welcome back to our tutorial series on web development by Technical Club RCOM. In the last video we talked about some basic HTML tags such as divs, anchor tag, headings, footer, body tag, etc. If you have not seen it, I highly recommend you to watch the HTML introductory video. In this video we will learn about CSS and a CSS framework called Bootstrap. Before starting off with CSS and Bootstrap, let's see what we created in the last video. This web page is not up to the mark, I would say. What we want is to create a basic portfolio which showcases our skill set. Like this. This is the actual design that we want to create. The problem with our web page is that it is not styled properly. This can be done with CSS. CSS is nothing but cascaded style sheet. It is a document where we target HTML tags and style them. For example, targeting a p tag and increasing the font size, aligning text, changing font color, etc. It's like giving clothes to your naked HTML document. Let me show you how we can target HTML elements and style them. Basically, there are four ways to style HTML tags. The first is by declaring the tag name. Here it is p tag. And within the curly brackets, you write the properties. By doing this, these properties will be applied to all the p tags in the document. The next is by specifying the style in the tag itself by the style attribute. What you do is write all the properties in a single line inside the opening tag. Thus, this is also called as inline CSS. Inline CSS also has highest priority while applying CSS properties. If you apply styles in the style sheet and also mention styles in the inline CSS, the style sheet CSS will be overridden by the inline CSS. The next method is by using the classes and ID. This is usually done when you want to apply CSS properties to similar HTML tags. Classes are used to group similar elements who have common properties, whereas IDs are always unique. To apply CSS by targeting classes, we will write dot or period followed by class name. Here we have a div with class Google and it can be styled by using dot Google and writing the CSS properties within the brackets. And for applying CSS using IDs, we will write hashtag followed by the ID name. We have a div called Facebook which has ID Facebook. And its CSS will be hashtag Facebook and inside the bracket we will write all the CSS properties. So let's dive right into making our web portfolio more appealing and presentable. First go to your folder where you have created the HTML document and open it in VS Code. And make another file called index.css. So click on this new file button. Type in index.css. Here I'm using the same file name as index.html. You can use any name you want. Press enter and then CSS file is created for you. Now whatever styles property that we write in the index.css file has to be linked to the index.html web page. For that we have to add a link tag. So here you can give the path of the index.css file. As the index.css file is just right beside the index.html and they are in the same folder, I can specify the relative path. The VS Code provides me with the file name automatically. So now the index.css file is linked with the index.html file. Now if I want to style some tag in this document, I can do it. Let me show you. If I want to style this p tag, I'll say p. Let's say
color equal to red, font size. Here you can see VS Code already gives you so many values. This is because of Emmet extension. So let's say extra large. Let's save this. You can click on this go live button to run the live server. It will automatically open the document for you in the browser. See. Here you can see the P tag has changed its font color to red and the font size is also increased to extra large. Now if I change to 10 pixel, see the P tag font has changed. So this is how the CSS file can be used to style the HTML tags. Now we can try writing our web page again, but first let us examine our design and make some conclusions out of it. For that, let's go to our design once. So in this design, what we can observe is that we have a header and then we have a landing section which occupies full width. Then there is another section called as the services section, and there's a footer. In the landing section, we can see that there's a text. Below that, there are two buttons. And on the right hand side, we have an image. In the services section, we have six cards, six bootstrap cards. We will see from the documentation what are cards. And in the footer, we have a heading, then we have a subheading, and then there are some social icons, and then there is a subtitle line. So this skeleton, so this examination of our design is very important, as we are prepared that what are the sections that we need to create. And we have divided our web page into smaller problem statements. Now when we look at our first section, which has the header and the landing section, it can be further divided into a full navbar or the header, which occupies full width. Then in the landing section, we have a container fluid. As I showed you in the Bootstrap documentation, HTML fluid class occupies full width, and thus it is called full width wrapper or the container fluid class. Inside that, we will need container, only container, which has margins from left and right. And then there's a content wrapper and then the image wrapper. And then there can be a heading, and then can be again two more headings as per our design, and then there can be a P tag, a paragraph, and then there can be two buttons. There are two bootstrap buttons as I showed you in the documentation, and in the image wrapper we can place an image. So this examination, this conclusion, that this preparedness, that how many divs you want to create, where will be the P tag, how many headings do you want, where the headings there should be, how many wrappers do you want. So this makes it a lot easy to structure our HTML code. In the next section, we have the services section. So in this, there's nothing much. There's a container which has margins on the both sides, left and right. And then there are six cards. So we have to arrange this six card in the center. So this cards, this bootstrap cards, can directly be copy pasted from the bootstrap documentation, and it readily gives you this gray area, gray header area, and the content area in the card. And in the CSS, we will customize this card according to our need. We will specify some minimum width and height for the cards. So this is about the examination of our design. And now we can start writing our HTML code according to it. Now we can write a whole lot of CSS and make our document well styled, but there are tools which we can leverage to save our time, and that tool is Bootstrap. For example, let me show you a file where I have written a lot of CSS to style up one single web page, and this is all without Bootstrap. So you can imagine the amount of time it had taken me to write this. So I am sharing you a very wonderful tool called Bootstrap, which we can use to save our time and write less code. People at Bootstrap have done a wonderful job. They have provided us with a tool, lot of useful CSS code, which we can access for free. Bootstrap basically has a JS file and a CSS file, which together give us many pre-written, ready-to-use, stylish and pixel-perfect components to embed directly in our web page. Let me show you it in the browser and with the documentation. And for that, all we have to do is download their files from their website and link it to our HTML document, or load these files from a remote server. Here we will be using the Bootstrap files from the remote server. So from this web page, just copy this CSS link and the JS link, any one of these. So I'll click on copy and paste it in my head, the HTML document. So here goes my Bootstrap CSS. I'll save it and let me copy the JS. So I don't need all of these. I'll just say this PNG. So now I have linked the CSS and the JavaScript live file of the Bootstrap in my head of the HTML document. Okay, so remember one thing, do not paste the script tag in the head of the document, paste it in after the body tag. Now since we are on the Bootstrap documentation, let me give you guys a quick tour. It is very essential that you get yourself familiar with this documentation. Now, first of all, let's see the layout tab. You see, they have created a class called container. So if you just apply a class called container to the div tag, it will look like this. And here they have mentioned use container fluid for a full width container spanning the entire width of the viewport. So this container will now occupy the entire width of the document when we apply a container fluid class. So all I wanted to say that Bootstrap has created classes for us which are specified in this CSS file of theirs. So we just have to call or specify these classes according to our need, and those styles will be applied to our HTML tags. But before that, we need to know what are the style class names and what do they do. For that, you must read the documentation of Bootstrap version 4.0, because in this tutorial, we'll be using Bootstrap version 4. Now, there are so various components which Bootstrap offers, such as alerts, there are badges, the new which is written here, these are the badges, and there are of many types. there are buttons. So all you need to do is specify these classes to a button, and this type of button will be created. If you apply button primary, then a blue colored button with white text will be created. And look at the border radius and size of the button and the hover effect. All this comes pre-written, and you just have to specify and remember this class name. There are button groups. There are so many things like forms. All this whole form can just be created by copy pasting this code and modifying it later according to the use case. There are models. Models are just the popover. There is a nav bar which comes in very handy. So all this code you could have written manually and spend more time, but Bootstrap offers it out of the box. You just need to remember few tag class names, or just copy this whole code and delete or edit the HTML tags according to the navbar you need. Now let's begin writing our web page with a clean slate, and let me introduce you to another shortcut which will save lots of time. That is Shift 1, and just press enter. So this gives you a HTML basic boilerplate. Boilerplate does the repetitive part for you, that writes the HTML opening and closing tag and the body tag and the head tag. So directly you can write or start coding inside the body tag. But before that, let's paste in our Bootstrap necessities or the dependencies. That is the CSS link and the script tag link. And let's cut that and paste it after the body. Now, as per our design, we need a header. So, just a minute. For that navbar, we'll take help from the Bootstrap documentation. So let's head over to Bootstrap documentation and copy the navbar code. We'll later modify, as we don't need the search bar and search button, and we'll modify this content of the links. Let's head over to our code and paste it. Okay, we have our navbar. Let's save it and view it in our browser. How does it look? Yeah, so this is what a navbar, Bootstrap navbar, looks like when it is rendered. So we'll modify this, we'll remove this, and we'll update the content link here. You'll type in your name. And in the design, it is in bold letters. So we'll do get wrong. So what I did is I had to wrap your name with strong tag. So I just selected it and I pressed Ctrl Shift and W. So if you write in P tag, if I want to wrap this up into a span, so I'll just write span and then press enter. So the whole content is now wrapped up into a span. So that's how you can easily do wrapping. I don't need span right now, so I'll just Control C. Yeah, so let's then look. Yeah, so your name appears here, bold letters. Now we'll update link to projects. And we don't need this drop down, so I'll just delete it. I don't need All right, I'll just update it here. Projects, then about. Right. Let's save that and see. Yeah, home, projects and about, and your name is highlighted, and we need to remove this search form. So I'll just delete. That's it. Your navbar has been created. So you see, that's how fast you can create a very classy navbar with Bootstrap without writing much of the code and just modifying the code provided by Bootstrap.